I'm going to introduce you, and then I'm just going to sit here.
Okay. You got an easy job.
Huh?
Today, you have an easy job.
Yeah, exactly.
For this next few minutes.
Ladies and gentlemen, we want to welcome you to our press conference today. I'm Jay Sampson, Perkins Point Communications here in Union, and I would like to turn this over to our Director of Athletics, Tim Curry, to introduce our new head football coach.
Jay, can everybody hear me? Usually don't have a problem. Welcome. Thank all of you for coming to this opportunity to welcome our new head football coach to Union College, Mr. Zak Willis.
Well, first of all, I'd like to thank Coach Curry and the committee for giving me the opportunity to be here at Union. Very, very excited about being here and see a tremendous amount of potential. I've been able to go out and watch the guys practice and was pleasantly surprised. You usually don't see that much talent on a 3-8 football team. We feel like we've got already headed in the right direction. We've got ourselves headed in the right direction, and really thankful to be here. Well, I think the first thing that got my attention was the people, and I'm talking about in the administrative roles that we have here at Union. You know, the quality of the people, the way the interview was conducted, how well organized it was, and how friendly everybody was, and the fact that they were looking for someone to help develop character and build character through football into the young people here really got my interest going in the program. Well, I think it's exciting. I always enjoyed competing in the Mid-South, and when I was here before, they called it the little SEC because anybody could beat anybody, and I remember our first year of varsity at Pikeville, I started that program. We played Lambeth, and they were about 15th in the country, and we were down 35-7 with 8 minutes to go in the third quarter and came back and won the game 44-42 with a bunch of freshmen. And Vic Wallace, who was in Lambeth's coach, came across the field and said, "See, I told you anybody can beat anybody," and kind of laughed. And that's what I've taken, because I know last year at halftime, the Cumberland game, we were tied 21-all with them on their home field. So it just shows you how tough this conference is and how hard it is to really win. But if you can get out of it and get into the playoffs, our teams usually do very well. Well, anytime you go into any endeavor, you got to believe you're going to be successful. So I believe we'll be successful. To what degree depends on how much the players embrace our philosophy and what we've got to do. We've got a lot of hard, tough, painful work ahead of us to get to where we need to be as a program. But I believe we've got a staff here that understands what needs to happen. And when that happens, we can sell that to the players. And really most of what we've got to accomplish is between our ears. And that involves attitude, that involves values, that involves personal conduct off the field. And when we get those things lined up, the wins usually take care of themselves.
I know earlier you mentioned that you were impressed with the talent. What are some of the other strengths that you see coming into this program?
Well, I think, you know, really the biggest thing that I have seen here is a continuity, philosophically speaking, from the administration all the way through to the coaching staff. It's been one message to me, and that's, Coach, we've got to, you know, build our character and be more mentally tough. And we're boiling it down to responding to adversity. Whether it's on the field or off the field, we've got to be able to respond to adversity in a positive way and to be able to battle through whatever comes our way that may not be in our favor and turn it into something that's positive for us. And that wins football games, but that also changes lives. I like the community. I think the campus is beautiful. You know, we're not a huge campus, but everything here is, I call it small but first class. You know, the facilities here, if you look at our football stadium, we don't hold 80 or 90,000, but everything's right where it needs to be. We've got a beautiful playing surface that, you know, is weather resistant. other sports can use it. I like the fact that the football team's not set off by itself, but it's a part of the community, and we need to further integrate it in, and I believe you can do that here. A lot of places you go trying to integrate your program into the mainstream of the community is tough to do, but I don't believe it will be here. Well, it'll metamorphosize as we go. In other words, is I'm going to fit our scheme to what our players are able to do. My job as a coach, I believe, is to put our players in the best possible position to be successful. You know, a lot of coaches come in, they have their own playbook and their own terminology, and one man knows everything and everybody else has to learn. At this point, probably 120 people have to learn what I want them to do. I would rather learn their terminology, fit it to my framework and scheme, and go forward, because it reduces the learning curve on what guys need to do. And I think that's been one of the big reasons I've been successful at turning other programs around, is because of that. So we want to run the football. If we have to throw the football first to run it early on, we will. It all depends on our offensive line. I think we got a lot of talent at the skill positions. We got to get guys the ball out in space where they can make somebody miss and make a play. Once we get to where we can run right at you and you can't stop us, we'll be putting rings on our fingers. And that's where we want to go, and we need to be able to play great defense. And I was watching them the other day. We've got some work to do there, but we've got the talent to do it with.
Well, going through the process, obviously the first thing that stuck out in my mind as I went through it was looking at his success as a head football coach at schools very similar to Union, starting the program at Pikeville and from scratch and being able to win there, and then taking a program in Newberry, which is a Division II school, NCAA, but is very similar to Union in size, that had struggled on the football field and was able to turn that program around very, very quickly and win championships there. So, you know, that was one of the things, obviously, that when I started to go through resumes and look at the some 300-odd applicants that we had, that kind of stuck out in my mind immediately.
Just, you know, the biggest thing we need is support. And we are going to have an open-door policy. My door is open. You know, there's obviously obligations I have, but to the college community, to the students here and the faculty, you know, our priority is to take care of things off the field first the right way, and then their success will come on the field. And I think that's the most important thing, is the image of our program's got to improve. Our character's got to be solid, rock solid, and we know we need the community support to do that.
Thank you all for coming out today. And new era of Union football. Zak Willis.